This is a production of PBS 39.
As our economy takes a downturn, we'd like to offer some money-saving tips. Tonight's Consumer Corner can put green in your pocket and green up the environment. ConsumerReports.org lists the following suggestions concerning driving. Accelerate smoothly, brake gradually, and just slow down. It's safer and uses less gas. Aggressive driving can lower your gas mileage by 33% at highway speeds. A roof rack can decrease an SUV's fuel efficiency by 5%. At home, you can save money by replacing incandescent bulbs with compact fluorescent bulbs. They last longer and can save you at least $30 in energy costs over the bulb's lifespan. But the mercury inside CFLs means you should take them to a recycling center to dispose of them instead of throwing them in the trash. Consumer Reports states lowering your home's temperature 5 to 10 degrees at night and when no one is home. That can slash your heating costs up to 20% a year. And here's a great excuse to avoid washing your dishes in the sink or pre-rinsing them. Consumer Reports found that the added step can waste 20 gallons of heated water a day. Those are just a few tips to help reduce your carbon footprint and save you money at the same time. That's a look at tonight's Consumer Corner. While most of us try to conserve water when we wash our hands or brush our teeth, which can save us money too, but do you ever give the water and where it comes from a second thought? It's a basic necessity that most of us take for granted. But there's millions of people around the world without a safe source of running water. Laura McHugh introduces us to some area college students pouring their time and sweat into bringing that little luxury to one Latin American community.
10 years after Hurricane Mitch tore through Central America, many communities continue down the road to recovery. According to U.S. government reports, the hurricane claimed 11,000 lives and left at least as many missing. The storm hit Honduras the hardest, leaving $4 billion worth of damage. In the village of Pueblo Nuevo, visitors say the 1,500 residents still don't have a reliable water source, and the water they do have is contaminated with bacteria and parasites.
They're not treating the water, so they're getting the water from a spring, which is should be clean, but it's contaminated, and so they're drinking dirty water.
And we met with the doctor in town, and he told us that if the water supply was improved, if we could deal with the contamination issues, that he predicted that he would see 50% less illness in the local clinic.
As the president of the Lehigh University chapter of Engineers Without Borders, Eric Putnam traveled to Pueblo Nuevo. The organization partners engineers and engineering students with developing communities around the world. In this case, the members plan to get the village's water distribution system back in working order.
It was an issue of water quantity and water quality, that they would turn their water on in the morning and then they'd have to turn it off for the majority of the day. So they would fill up these big basins with water, and that would be the water they would have to use all day long.
It was kind of a shame that they didn't have this clean water, and it was kind of weird to see that they had things like DVD players, but they were lacking the basic necessity of water.
We want to do that back and forth about 10 times.
Kevin Myers brought his passion for the issue back home. We recently caught up with Kevin as he led 8th graders at Brockle Middle School through an experiment on water filtration.
A big part of what we want to do is educate people on the lack of clean water in the world.
Using water collected from a local creek, Kevin began the experiment by having students shake up the liquid, then pour it from one container to another.
We're going to want to pour the water into the beaker carefully.
Some students measured out chemicals to treat the water, and others added food dye. Every group created their own filter using sand pebbles and a coffee filter.
Our goal with working with Brockle is, first of all, just to let them know about another part of the world and sort of help them understand that there are kids their age go to school like they do, but they don't have water in their homes, which is something I think all of us take for granted.
After 3 days in the classroom, the impact they were having on the younger students became clear.
Actually, they brought up many philosophical questions that even I don't have answers for.
Well, I always knew there was a problem, but I saw that there was a bigger problem than what most Americans think it is.
Sometimes, you know, we may wake up and just turn on the faucet and we put a toothbrush, you know, all that water wasting when we could just, like, turn off the water in every break instead of leaving it flow.
It was unbelievable the level they caught on. We were trying to progress them through questions and they'd answer one question with what we were expecting the answer for the next question to be.
Though they simplified the process for the 8th graders, the Lehigh students will build basically the same kind of filter in Pueblo Nuevo along with a water storage tank, just on a much larger scale.
So it'll be a 9-foot high, 20-foot diameter concrete block circular tank which we have no idea how to do.
The students get some practice by building a model of the storage tank they designed. First, they add water to concrete mix. Then the students begin layering large blocks into a circle and filling the gaps with mortar by hand. During two trips planned over the next year, the students hope to see the tank built, a filter and chlorinator installed, and any breaks or cracks in the distribution system repaired.
I really hope that I'm able to be there when we, flick the switch and turn on the pump and get the water going.
The students know they'll never erase the damage done by Hurricane Mitch, but hope to give these residents back one of the necessities that the storm stole. For Tempo, I'm Laura McHugh reporting.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39, thank you.
Thank you.